Hello friends, welcome back to Getting Yourself Organized with OrgMode, my little screencast about OrgMode. The last two times we were talking about exporting, and today we want to talk about publishing. Publishing is a bit like exporting, but it's a bit more because you combine a bunch of files to a project and you want to automate a lot of things that you say, I want to publish everything that is maybe an org file, I want to publish to an HTML. And we will now see how we do it. So for this example, we really stick to, we want to publish to HTML, and we want this HTML be located on our home directory in public HTML. Because my web server on this machine is an Apache and I'm running a Debian 8. And the easy thing is you can configure Apache so that it takes the contents from public HTML in the user home directory and puts it on the web practically. But it's a functionality that is not enabled by default. So you have to enable it first. That means you log in as root. And then you change to the etc Apache 2 mods enabled directory. And here you create two symbolic links. One to /mods available user.conf with the name user.conf, and the same procedure for user.load. Then you have those two symbolic links in the user in the mods enabled directory. And then all you have to do is system control restart Apache 2 service. That means you start restart Apache so that the new settings take place. And then you can try it out. If I use Apache on localhost, my machine, you see I get the default page. If I use my Rainer home directory, my name, my user ID, you see I have made a simple HTML file in 2004. It's there since then, I never touched it again and so on, but whatever. But for our examples here, we have a user created that is called Joe. So we can see it shows public HTML and we get a forbidden. That's bad, but that has a reason. If you look, we are here inside Joe. And Joe has no public HTML, so you say make dir public HTML, and now let's refresh, and you see I get an index of Joe. Of course, there is no file at all, but the function that I can see what's inside public HTML works. So in the next step, what we have to do is config the .emacs file for OrgMode, because you want to publish your org files, and that means you have to create a setting org publish project a list. It's a list of projects that you want to publish, and the the syntax is quite easy. You have a name of a project, in this case it's org. That is what I took from the manual. This was the easy example that I took and tried out, because honestly I don't publish at all, because for me getting my things or getting myself organized is a personal organization. It's my own time management system, and there is no need to publish that. But of course, if you would create maybe slides with OrgMode, or you create tables or whatever, then you can publish. But for this example, we just pretend we publish every org file that we have and we put it on the web server. So to do so, we need some properties inside this org project. One is that we define a base directory. That means where are my source files that I want to publish located. This is the home directory and then the subdirectory org. If you see ls org, there's a lot of things that we collected during all the previous videos, and Then we say we want to publish into public HTML, the file, the directory that we just created. Then very important, that is missing in the manual, and so when you try the publishing function from the manual, it doesn't work and you get crazy. You need a publishing function property that says, okay, every file I take, I want to publish org to HTML, and then it's just a setting. I don't want section numbers and I don't want a table of contents. So when this is inside your .imax file and you start IMAX and you open one of your org files like I have here, then you can use, this is what we already did. We are inside localhost show, but it's empty, and now we are here and I can call the export dispatcher. So I do it very slow now because I got a comment recently that says I'm too fast in typing all the control keys. Note, this basic slides don't have the nice keyboard font, so I used what's written in the manual. It's a controls, the capital C stands for control, and then control C, control E. You can see I press control and C, and then I press control and E. And now I'm here in the public in the export dispatcher, and you see I have down here the publishing function. So that means I can press Shift P, capitalized P, and now I have those four options highlighted, and I will choose all projects. So you have to have a look at the status line of this IMAX window, because now a lot of things will happen. If I press A, you see down here there was a lot of things that happened, and if I go now to my web browser and I refresh it, then you see, oh, I have a lot of files here. I have by the mylife.org file exported, you see, or I go back and I have this daily plan that someday in June we created, and I have my board table that I was, when I was explaining the tables function, I have a review from my review files, and I have a text when we created, when we talked about the links and the special links that we can use inside org mode. I have my books list there where I export my tracked books. So you see, these are archive entries from home my life org, where all the books that I read or that Joe read. And I have my work HTML. You see what's still in there. I have those export from the last snippet, but this time exported to HTML. So you see it doesn't look so good because the org file was originally made to be exported to Beamer slides. So here are still things missing, as I explained in the last video, and so on. You see everything what I have, also my archive, everything what's in the archive is exported here. So that's practically a very easy way to publish something on your web server and to export things that you want to share. But as I said before, as far as my to-do lists and all my tasks that I have to do are concerned, I'm not really eager to share that with somebody. I mean, if I want to share some things, then I will export parts of it, and some things are for public maybe, but some things are really just my stuff, and there is no need to share it with anyone. But of course you can export or publish documents with org mode or whatever, you want to publish, you see how it's going, and it's easy. One thing that I have additional information, because let's do something now. I say family business, there is nothing in here. Maintenance, I make a logbook entry now. Washed the car today, just to, and so save this, and now we publish again. C, E, publish, and let's say current project, and now you see this line here, skipping unmodified file, homejoe.org, dailyplan.org. That means your dailyplan.org, if you look here at the timestamps, this 1746, the thing that should change now, because it's 1715, is at mylife.org, so let me refresh, and you see my life HTML is 1749, every other timestamp is still there where it is. So we can now look here, and you see hopefully my logbook entry, washed the car today. But that's it. And you see that org mode is doing some housekeeping, some bookkeeping of what it already exported. And this is the additional information, because org mode keeps the timestamps of all exported files in the home directory, in a directory that is hidden, that is called .org timestamps. And as long as your file is not newer than what's in org timestamps, it won't call the export function again. So I was a bit puzzled before, because I said, okay, I do everything. I do a test run, and then I do the video, and I show you how you export everything to public HTML. And then really I just got one file exported and the rest was not there, and I was really puzzled and said, oops, what's going on here? And then I found out, okay, they really keep timestamps. Org timestamps. You see there is one file, org cache, and I guess inside there is a Lisp function that says these are the timestamps of my files that I already exported. So I don't have to do the export function again, it's just to save time. But of course, if you ever go and delete public HTML and you say, okay, I want to recreate it again, you should also delete the timestamps. Otherwise, you don't easily publish everything again to public HTML. Okay, folks, that's all for today. Thanks a lot for watching and for following my YouTube channel and all the comments. And I still have stuff in the pipeline to be produced as small videos, so I'll be back sooner or later with the next video. And until then, enjoy working with org mode. Thanks.